to know. With me here in the studio today is Tanushree Dutta. And she needs no introduction now. She's been in the headlines for about a week now.
Yeah.
A little longer than a week.
Perhaps, yeah.
I spoke to Tanushree a few days back and I invited her to one of my programs and debate shows in the evening. At that time, she said she was not completely comfortable. She also told me that what has been happening in the last few days had taken a toll on her. So we took some time out. And then I told Tanushree then that when you're ready, come back and we'll talk. And since she's here today, I don't want to settle this matter. I don't think it can be settled. But I want you to speak as frankly as possible. And I also want to begin by telling you that I will not be giving you a platform, assuming that I agree with everything you say. I am quite proud of what you've done. I think a lot of people are, your family members will be, people across the country will be, women will be, and men will be. But having said that, I want to go through every detail. The idea is not to put you in an inquisition chamber or interrogation chamber because you don't deserve to be, but for you to give your side of the story and then take it from there and let the viewers judge. Tanushree?
Yes.
So first of all, welcome.
Thank you.
And Tanushree, on the 21st of July, you put up an Instagram post about flying back to Mumbai from the United States. I have that with me, with glasses, all very excited. And today you find yourself in the middle of all kinds of legal suits, political battles. Tanushree versus Raj Thackeray one day, God knows who other. When you were taking that flight back, did you make up your mind that this time I'm going to go back and I'm going to fight and take Nana Patekar head on publicly? Because the matter was not settled since 2008.
No, I had no thoughts in that direction. In fact, I was just telling you this, that before I took the flight, my concerns was what kind of wardrobe will I have in India and how hot is it going to be here? Because as you know, in the US, it's the summers and we've had a very, very harsh and long winter this time in the tri-state area. And we were all looking forward to summers so that we can do all the outdoor activities and stuff. And I was between jobs and between homes. I just recently moved to the suburbs, trying to get my own apartment and settle in. But that apartment didn't work out for some reason. And they said, why don't you try after a couple of months? You know, when we are closer to winter, apartments are more readily available compared to summers. And I was stubborn about that particular apartment in that particular neighborhood. And I had big dreams about my life moving forward, you know, the American suburban life, which is what I have always thought about. Anyways, my mom said, oh, why don't you come home? Because, you know, we've not seen you in a long time. This year, we're not planning to come to the US. So you come home, stay with us for a few months and then go back and get, you know, get that apartment. And that's how I took the flight. And the last night before the flight, my concerns with my local friends in New Jersey was, it's going to be so hot. How am I going to stay there? You know, summers are fine, but heat is not.
One minute. I can't believe what you're saying.
I know.
No, because the picture that many people have is of a scheming, Machiavellian, cunning, planning Tanushree who wants to get back and who wants to use an incident, true or not, apocryphal or not. She wants to revive the controversy, make herself a celebrity, bigger, back over again, take revenge on Nana Patekar, enter Big Boss, make lots of money, re-enter the Bollywood career and use this to make a comeback. I mean, that is exactly what is being alleged on you. And here you are telling me that you were planning this quiet suburban life in the US.
Yes.
And this came as a shock to you. Why should I believe you?
I don't know. It's really up to you. Because let me try and answer some of those allegations. Nobody in their right mind would put themselves through what I'm going through, with legal notices slapped on me, with threats issued to me of mob violence, legal threats, knowing full well the legal system of our country, the justice system of our country, is never something that anybody would want to get into. Having been a victim, you know, court cases go on for years and years. In this country, if you want to harass a woman and re-harass a woman, you drag her to court.
Yep.
And you know, it will just go on for years and then the matter will become sub judice. The media will have to shut up, I'll have to shut up, everybody shuts up, and sub judice matter in the court can just go on and on and on.
Plus, so that's exactly it. It doesn't cause anyone damage. So I mean, I'm being cynical about it.
It causes damage to me because I don't live here anymore. Why would I want to come to this country and get embroiled in all this? Plus the slut shaming, plus the, you know, the smear campaigns that are being run on me. I have gone through all of this 10 years ago.
You say slut shaming, smear campaign, explain.
You know, people are saying all kinds of things, like Nana Patekar, his group, they're putting people in front on social media, spreading lies, misinformation. Of course, they're going to do that. They're not going to admit it, right? Hey, yeah, we harassed her. They're not going to do that. They're obviously going to combat it. This is an age-old saga in our country. Every time a woman has ever spoken up, she gets dragged. She gets shamed and condemned.
3 days back, we had someone on my program. I did a show on the day that you did not come. And one person on the program said that, what is she complaining about? I think it was Barkhat Rehan. She said, what is she complaining about? She's an actress. So what if someone touches her? What's the big deal? I don't know if you heard that comment.
It horrified me. It horrified me because I think she's misinformed. It's not touching. It's about consent. And it was supposed to be a solo song right from day one.
Okay, one minute. Should we go into the details?
Yeah, let's do that.
We'll go into the details of what happened that day. So it's 10 years. First question is, you remember every moment.
Absolutely.
It's clear in your mind.
Yes, absolutely. Everything.
The footage of you leaving that set has gone viral. Your words are being played out again and again. I want to take you back to 2008, not to take you through the trauma, but because I think you need to relive it in the course of this interview.
There is no trauma and emotional charge associated with it anymore.
There
was at one point of time. It was very, very hurtful. But now in 8 years, maybe some bit of it has remained. Now when I'm facing the whole thing again, it makes me a little indignant as a human being that I can't believe it. This is happening all over again. And the same allegations of publicity stunt that were thrown at me 10 years ago are being thrown at me today.
Yeah.
I cannot believe it.
Exactly the same and worse.
Yeah. I mean, if I wanted publicity, wouldn't I have gone and done that song? I would have gotten more publicity out of it because that song would have played on TV for 30 days, played and replayed. And I would have made the money that I was promised in that song. They didn't give me anything. They canceled my checks and everything. And I would have gone ahead and done shows on that song, multiple shows, and been rich.
Yeah.
And I would have gotten publicity.
Yeah.
Why would someone make themselves go through this? Being a woman and in this country, yeah, knowing full well the court system, the legal justice system, the law and order system. I can understand if somebody does that in America.
Mm.
Because, you know, even if they get dragged to court, or even if they are dragging someone to court, 3 weeks and justice, you know, convictions.
You know, when all of these things happen, I'll tell you one thing. People look upon you, and I'll tell you very clearly the reason I did not push you to do the interview with me 3 days back was because I could sense a sense of discomfort. I'm telling you right now that, you know, seeing your reaction to this, nobody associates with the emotion that you experienced that day, but for perhaps the people who strongly and fiercely are there with you.
And the mob attack.
And the mob attack. In fact, when I saw pictures of the mob attack, it was horrible. I want to go through everything, but I want to go through it chronologically.
Yeah.
And any point you feel, right, that you don't want to talk about it, that's fine. But no, I've seen your statements over the last 10 years, and I've heard the chatter on the other side with a sense of disbelief. And the allegation really on you, and there are allegations on you, is that the facts of your case are sketchy, that you're blowing something out of proportion. That's the first thing, that it's sketchy. How does she remember? She's blowing it out of proportion. The first reaction on you, Tanushree, is that you're overreacting. I don't agree with it, but I'm sure you heard this. She's overreacting, right? First, I want to start with your response to that.
Because in our country, women have, for time immemorial, have been told to not make a big deal about harassment. Harassment is ingrained in our country and our system. We have movies, old movies. I remember as a child watching old movies and thinking to myself that this is weird. This guy is behaving like this with this girl in a song, and then she marries him. She falls in love with that guy. Harassment is popular culture, and people are told to keep shut about it. Even rape victims and rape survivors are asked to keep shut and, you know, shove everything under the carpet. That is the culture. That is the mindset. There is so much shame and stigma that gets associated with a victim. Shouldn't it be the other way around? Shouldn't it be somebody who's doing something horrendous to another person, be accountable to themselves, and they should be ashamed?
But the argument that has been made out by male chauvinists, sexists, and misogynists is that if a woman wears a certain kind of clothes, or is in a certain profession, or is walking on the streets at a certain time of the night, she deserves
she it. Calls, she's calling
she's
for
calling
it.
Calling for it.
That is also a part of the reason why 10 years ago, this, you know, whole thing, it erupted. I spoke, I gave interviews, people covered it, but there was
So you were on the sets of Horn OK Please in 2008. You said that you were supposed to be in a solo dance sequence and Nana Patekar insisted that it became a quote unquote sleazy duet. Can you shed some light on what exactly happened? What were you told? How were you told?
So I agreed to do the song after much coaxing. We did the rehearsals.
Coaxing as in why?
Coaxing as in like I was not sure if I wanted to do the song. I think somewhere my instinct and intuition was trying to tell me, you know, to rather go on a holiday or something. So I kept going back and forth. And they really wanted me in the song. So they kept coming after me. The producers, director, the producer and director. And they convinced me to do the song. They came home, they made me hear the song. My dad was there, he's involved in my work, and you know, he also takes joint decisions, takes care of my finances and everything. So I was like, okay, let me do the song. It sounds like a nice song, and you know, I could, you know, when you do item songs, we don't make much money making movies as actresses. So you supplement your income by doing the songs, because then you get shows, and you know, you get events. So I was like, hey, let's do the song. It's a good song. Anyways, we do the rehearsals. We go to the set, start shooting. Nana Patekar is there on set. I find it odd. I tell the director and producer, what's he doing on the set? He's not supposed to be in the song. They say, oh, no, unka ek line hai bas. Wo line wo le lenge, unka alag se hum shoot kar lenge. Gaane mein ek male line hai. Male voice ka line hai. Wo unka alag se shoot kar denge, phir ko ghar bhej denge. So I said, okay, fine. But he doesn't go home. They shoot the line with him. And the rest of the song is supposed to be picturized solo on me, you know, the dancing pits and everything. Wo nahi gaya ghar. He's still on the set and he's weird, like he's staring at me, he's not responding to general greetings that, you know, when you come on set, you say hello, hi, good morning, good afternoon. He doesn't respond, he just keeps giving that weird stare. But I forgive that, because I would not hold somebody up for being weird and being obnoxious and an asshole, because you come across enough of those in the film industry. Sure. So I'm like, okay, maybe he's gonna, you know, be all right. Slowly, he continues that vibe and then he starts getting closer to me. And now he grabs me by the arm, pushes me around, idhar khadi rahe, udhar khadi rahe. Then he tells the choreographer and the dancers to move away. And then he starts teaching me how to dance. You know, like, he's just pushing me around. Like, I'm like this, just stand here, stand there. And he's teaching me how to dance. And I'm like, what's going on? And I'm overwhelmed because I have never had that kind of an experience with another actor.
How many people were watching this happen?
Everybody on set. But for them, it was not odd because apparently this is how actors sometimes behave. But I was not used to it because all the actors that I've ever worked with from the first film were always people who kept a distance unless it was part of the script and I had consented to,
that,
you know, a scene.
That footage is not available of him doing that.
Pushing me around, yeah. Because that was, I don't know, it's not
Why?
Available. I don't know.
There were reporters there, there were camera persons there.
See, the thing is, that was not on camera. The stuff that comes on camera is when the camera is rolling, like action.
No, but there's a part of the sequence where there is Ganesh Acharya trying to teach you a few steps and there's Nana Patekar there and then you walk away.
There was a camera crew which was shooting behind the scenes on the set.
Right.
So, whatever footage they have, they have. So
they would have had footage then. Of
they should have had.
So how come they didn't report
but
it?
But they were not like, you know, it's not like they're recording every moment of it. They're, you know, in and out. It's not like they're there all the time. Otherwise, they would have had footage worth, you know, 12 hours into three. Mm-hmm. You see what
sure.
I'm saying?
Yeah.
Each day.
So what did Nana Patekar do? Take it further from me.
Anyways, so that's where I saw the footage thing, that you cannot have moment by moment footage.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Next thing is I get a little rattled with this. So I go and complain to the producer, the director and choreographer separately, to three people. I call each of them one by one into my van and I speak with them, you know, while my...
Oh, you go off to the van and
I
then you...
I go back to the van because we broke
did
for lunch.
Did you say anything to Nana Patekar?
I didn't say anything to him because I think there's a better way of dealing
How
with things.
How long did this carry on, his harassment?
This was like that particular day. That particular day since morning.
How long did he do that?
I think that day morning when he came on set, he had bridged that distance from staring at me from a distance to kind of coming close, and now he was actually grabbing me and pushing me around. And all the while I'm thinking, he's not supposed to be here, he's not supposed to be here, he's not supposed to be anywhere near me. Why is he grabbing me and pushing me around? Why is he teaching me how to dance now? So this was the first half of the day. Then
that's not possible unless the directors, producers of the films allow it.
That's the weird thing. They're all watching.
So he's harassing you and they're all watching it.
Yeah, because in movie sets, sometimes actors, senior actors and male actors, they just get away with things and nobody else is able to say anything.
Hmm.
And this was the first time me experiencing it, and that's why I was freezing. I was like, I just didn't know what was going on around me. The environment was such that my brain has stopped functioning. I just knew that I was trying to keep calm, and I went and told these guys.
It's humiliating for you.
It's just like uncomfortable. Hmm. It's like horrible.
Hmm.
Because now I'm also threatened that दो दिन यू नो पहले मुझे देख रहा था दूर से घूर रहा था अभी धीरे धीरे वो नजदीक आ रहा है आई कुड फील दैट ही इज असेसिंग मी ही इज साइजिंग मी अप व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अ गर्ल इज शी समवन आई कैन ओवरपावर और शी समवन हु इज गोना जस्ट गिव इट ऑफ टू मी यू नो सो आई थिंक ही मेड हिज असेसमेंट एंड देन ही यू नो केम फॉरवर्ड टू यू नो टू पोर्ट्रे दैट हरासिंग बिहेवियर बुलिश बिहेवियर एंड सो एनीवेज आई गो एंड कंप्लेन टू द प्रोड्यूसर डायरेक्टर एंड द कोरियोग्राफर सेपरेटली एंड दे said, हाँ देखो ना हमें भी नहीं पता है वो सेट पे क्या कर रहा है हमने यू नो वी कांट इवन टेल हिम दैट बिकॉज इज अ सीनियर एक्टर यू नो लाइक दे ऑल्सो कैनॉट इंसिस्ट बट डोंट वरी वील टेक केयर ऑफ इट सो वेन आई वॉज कंप्लेनिंग टू देम दे डिड एक्नॉलेज
दैट
इट इज ऑड
व्हिच गणेश आचार्य सेज नाउ इज नॉट ट्रू
ऑफ कोर्स बिकॉज देन द वे द डे एंडेड ही बिकम्स party to it and he was complicit in it. He's
and then what happened? You went and complained to them?
So they said it's going to be fine. It's going to be sorted out. Okay. 2 hours later, they called me for rehearsals. Okay, before the take again. So I went to the set and this time, Ganesh Acharya's assistant comes and tells me, okay, I'll be showing you the step. And she shows me the step. This is a step where he has to fill me up and I have to, you know, get all felt up and everything. I was shocked. I was like, hey, just 2 hours ago, I complained about his proximity. I complained, I made a heavy complaint. It was not like, hey, I'm a little uncomfortable. It wasn't like that. I was angry. I was furious. I was just like, get this guy to leave, you know. And now they're saying, you know, you have to do this step. And I said, I'm sorry, I'm not going to do this. I told you guys, this is a solo dance sequence. Hmm. He's not supposed to be there.
So they added a sequence.
Yeah.
So he was grabbing you, pulling you, pushing you.
Haan,
you went to them and you said he's grabbing me, pulling me, pushing me.
Yeah.
And then he did it again. And you're also telling me that he just didn't harass you on day one, but over multiple moments.
See, day one, he was there on set when he was not supposed to be there. He was supposed to leave after his solo, that line.
Yeah.
He didn't leave. He kept being on the set. He kept being around me, you know, when my rehearsal is going on. So imagine, you know, this person is not supposed to be on set, but he's still there and he's always around you. He's always around you, staring at you. It is uncomfortable, but you can't complain about it because till the time he does something, you don't, you know. The next day, the same thing, you know, next day he started, you know, and I don't remember very clearly whether this incident happened on the second day of shooting or third day of shooting, but whichever this day was, the day where the day ended with my car being attacked and vandalized, that was the day where his obnoxiousness and his harassment was at its peak, because that was the day when he had figured out that she's a girl that I can get away, I can get away with this, with her.
Because the whole, everybody was supporting him.
Yeah, it was not like they were saying that, hey, you know, patting his back, like, hey, we are with you. But they were watching what is going on and they are
so
not.
So what did he do? Because, you know, I want this to go public before he does a press conference. When you say his harassment was at the peak and when you're suggesting that he was harassing you over multiple days on the set.
Multiple days. I told you the first two days.
First 2 days he was sort of watching you,
he
and
was
then
just kind
on
of
the
there
on
when
the,
he's
on,
not supposed to be there.
On the third day there were multiple incidents.
Yeah, like, you know, he. At one point of time, I remember he's grabbing me and pulling me.
Yeah.
Idhar khadi rahe, udhar khadi rahe.
Yeah.
And then after some time, when we are rehearsing again, he's telling the choreographers to stay away and teaching me how to dance. You know, all of this is not only odd, but it's like just offensive to me, because from day one, I've been mentioning that, you know, why is he on set? He's not supposed to be on set.
Well, obviously, there was a cabal of director, choreographer and producer which was supporting him. And
yes,
then the entire production
complicit.
Was essentially colluding.
Everybody
to
was
put
there.
You going, make you
just
go through it again.
Yeah.
Publicly.
And then
why?
And then they forced me.
Yeah.
Then they forced me to do the dance step. When I said to them that I cannot do this dance step, they came in, the producer, director and the choreographer. Now Nana is sitting right there. Now he can hear all of it. Any decent human being, a decent man would be like, the moment he would get an inkling that, you know, this girl is uncomfortable with this, he would come forward and say, hey, I don't want to be a part of this step if she's so uncomfortable with it. Right? Any decent human being, that's the response they'll have.
Without
he's sitting right there.
Yeah.
He's listening to the whole thing with these three guys literally hounding me that, no, you have to do this step. Ye to choreography karna padega. Calling me unprofessional on my face. And I could see through all that. I said, अभी इन्होंने माइंड बना लिया है कि मेरे को स्टेप करवा के छोड़ेंगे तो मेरे मुंह पे उनको मुझे अनप्रोफेशनल बोलना पड़े, यू नो टेंट्रम थ्रो कर रही है, वट एवर दे वॉन्ट टू से दे कैन से, बट आई एम नॉट पुटिंग माई सेल्फ इन दैट पोजिशन वेयर दिस गाय विल गेट टू फील मी अप ऑफिशियली बिकॉज इन अ डांस स्टेप, वो डांस स्टेप मैंने कर लिया होता तो आई विल नेवर हैव अ हरासमेंट क्लेम ऑन हिम बिकॉज इट वुड बी लाइक अरे तुमने तो डांस स्टेप अग्री कर लिया तब क्यों किया, मना करना चाहिए था.
That was the idea.
The thing is that किया तो प्रॉब्लम, नहीं किया तो प्रॉब्लम. अगर डांस स्टेप कर लिया होता तो आज बोलते कि
हाँ.
सो आई पुट माय फुट डाउन. आई सेड आई एम गोइंग, आई एम नॉट डूइंग इट, यू नो. आई वॉक्ड आउट, आई गोइंग टू माय वैन, आई कॉल माय मॉम, माय डैड एंड माय मैनेजर. सो अ मैनेजर इज नॉट ऑलवेज प्रेजेंट ऑन सेट्स, ही कम्स एंड गोज. व्हेनेवर देयर इज एन इशू ही इज देयर और ही यू कम टू चेक अप ऑन यू. दिस वाज अ टाइम व्हेन आई हैड टू हैव हिम ऑन सेट टू कम्युनिकेट विद दीज गाइज. नाउ 10 इयर्स बैक, लाइक आई एम 34 राइट नाउ, राइट? सो 24 आई वुड हैव बीन. सो And these guys were all like in their, like really old. So I'm thinking that I'm not able to communicate with these guys. I'm not able to, you know, just get through to them. And I can sense this, wo haavi ho rahe the mujh pe, you know, ki karna padega step, you know, unprofessional bula rahe. And I've seen that in the industry, you know.
And people, she was, and Anna Patikar was watching and enjoying.
He was watching right there. He was sitting in front of the screen.
It is like a setup for an official harassment
yes.
for hundreds of people.
Yeah.
And the person who is going to harass you is actually sitting there
yeah.
watching you prepare to get harassed officially.
Yeah, I mean, if he's that decent, when he heard all this, he could have simply said, arre, chhod do, nahi karna hai na usko.
And then what,
step.
You walked away?
So I walked away, walked into my van, called my mom, dad and my manager. They came on set. Now my dad and my manager go and start communicating with the director, producer and choreographer. Mm. Obviously my dad,
you said you didn't give in to manipulation and the pressure and you walked away.
Yeah,
that was the manipulation and pressure that was going on at that point of time. Then your mom and dad
came. And dad came and my manager came, and mom sat with me in the van with my hairdresser in the van, and my spot was outside the door. The van was not locked because people were going in and out. My dad was going in and out, my manager was going in and out. You know, you don't just lock the door because there are people who are going to come in. You don't know how to, you know. And I didn't have any threat of people coming into my van at that point of time.
Mm-hmm.
Because at that point of time, the Manse had not arrived and the media, you know, the crowd had not arrived. No reason for me to lock the van with my mom and my hairdresser in it. So dad and the manager, they went and start communicating with them. And clearly the communication was not happening because it was their inflated egos that had now gotten hurt.
Mm.
And they're not willing
How do they say that? How do they say that, you know, when your father goes out there and they say, my daughter is not comfortable with this scene where she's going to be physically harassed, how do they tell a father that we are going to officially harass your daughter and she's signed up for this and we will force,
sign up
no,
for
but
it.
You didn't, but they claim you did.
And my dad was there during the negotiations,
how do they do this?
Right? My dad, like I said, when they came to make us hear the song.
No, but this is disgusting.
My dad, it is
completely disgusting.
It is. My dad was there, right?
And you were sitting in the van waiting for the end of this
for
discussion.
Things to get sorted.
It's embarrassing, it's humiliating.
Another thing
for you?
Yeah. If my dad was not there, if he didn't know the details of the contract and if he was not involved in my work, then maybe there was some iota of doubt that my dad would have had that maybe she agreed for something, you know. But he was there. So he put his foot down. He's like, we were very clear from the beginning. Mm. It is going to be a solo dance sequence.
Mm.
And I tell my parents everything, right? If something is going on, I'm on the phone to my mom, lunch khaya, because my mom and dad don't believe that I've grown up yet.
Mm.
Even in America, they call me.
Mm.
And they know they have numbers of my friends.
Mm.
You know, if they don't find me, they think, you know, something has happened or whatever. So I tell them everything. So I had told my parents, they were aware of the situation. So when this situation escalated, my dad knew how to put his foot down. He said, my daughter is not going to do that step. You know, aap solve karo. And at one point of time, my dad gave them a suggestion ki, you know, बहुत ज़्यादा हो गया है अभी, बहुत ज़्यादा गर्म हो गए हो आप लोग, तो अभी एक काम करते हैं, अब सब घर जाते हैं चुपचाप शाम को, ठंडे दिमाग से सोचते हैं और नेक्स्ट डे हम.
What is Nana Patikar doing in all this?
Nana Patikar is inside the van and all this. He's gone inside the van and the communication is happening with the director.
It's unbelievable. People watching this program were actually hearing an official negotiation to harass a person which is going on. I mean, they're seeking permission to harass you.
Yeah.
Tanushree, you are alleging that the makers of the film, that's Rakesh Sarang, Sami Siddiqui, Ganesh Acharya, called in the media and the MNS to muscle flex and intimidate you. Is that correct?
Yes.
What proof do you have to corroborate this specific allegation?
Well, there is an eyewitness who came up and spoke, Janice. She has also corroborated that. And The MNS was there. That's also a fact. There are video footages of these guys damaging my car and everything.
I know the visuals of you leaving the set. The cameraman was jumping on top of your car. He was puncturing your tire.
He was the one who was outside the car. Yeah. He didn't stand up on the car.
Where did
the
guy turn up from? What was?
He was part of, the media crowd came, but this particular guy, was a nuisance creator. Another thing, Arnab, I want to mention, Manse is not just a party, it is also an ideology. Hmm. So there could be one lone, media reporter who could be sympathetic to their ideology. So when people try to put it ki nahi media ke saath fight hui thi, no, because the Manse was also there.
No, how did a swarm of, so you decided to leave?
Yeah, we decided to leave and I was, in the van just kind of getting ready to leave and everything. And we heard that the media has come. The spot boy comes inside and said, madam, abhi mat nikalna, media aa gayi, bheed ikatthi ho gayi hai. To abhi mat nikalna, thodi
der baad nikalna. They'd been called in.
Haan, and then we saw a door, vanity van door being banged like
by the media.
I don't know who was outside, but we heard the bang. Can you imagine how scary it is?
Somebody's ego got hurt.
They were already aggressive.
That you were not giving them official permission to harass you openly and, and therefore they attacked you.
Yeah. The crowd outside was already angry.
What were they angry with? What is their business?
I have no clue. That's the thing.
What are they angry about? That Nana Patekar didn't get to harass you? What was their frustration?
Probably. God knows what they were told when they were brought there. I just remember that I'm getting ready to leave. Dad said that we'll leave immediately. Mm. Yeah, tomorrow we'll sort out everything. Yeah. And the next thing I know, spot boy comes freaked out and he's like, madam, bahar mat nikalna. Puri bheed ikatha ho gayi hai, media aa gayi hai, manse ke log aa gaye hain, bahar mat nikalna. Theek hai. Lock kar diya fir van ko andar se. And I can hear banging the entire van. And these vans are not like lavish mansions. Mm. They're like tiny. If somebody's banging on your van door, it freaks you out. It scares you. And I'm thinking, and the producer had threatened me when I was walking out of the set. That, I will call the media on you. We'll, unprofessional. So bol rahe the.
What I find amazing here is that there are 200, 300 people harassing you. There's a camera person jumping on top of your car. There's one person, that same person is puncturing you. Your van is being attacked. I appreciate the fact that one reporter has come now. I mean, whatever it is worth after 10 years and said it happened. But I don't know about the reporter or the organization that he or she represented or the rest of the media. Why was this not a big deal then?
It was. For 3 days on national TV, these footages. Now, to ekad footages leak hue hain. Us waqt to all the TV channels had footages because they were all there. They had their own footages that they recorded while they were there. So while all this is going on and we are inside the car. So anyways, dad said, nikalna to pade gai, ab yahan pe baithe rahenge kya puri raat. So let's just try to get into the car and leave.
There was no conversation between you and Nana Patekar in all of this?
No, because...
No, not at all.
No, because I...
Did you ever tell him, don't do this, don't touch me,
no,
don't hold me,
no,
don't try to teach me to dance, don't let me do this, because did you tell him, no, don't do it? Why didn't you deal one-to-one with him?
I didn't say anything to him because usually when you have problems, you go and report to somebody in authority. So for me at that point of time, if he's a fellow actor, instead of saying something to him, I chose to tell it to the producer, director and choreographer.
Did he threaten you then? Was he threatening in his nature?
Yes, he was very threatening in his nature.
Describe that to me. As visually as you can, when you say threatening in his nature, there must have been something that you experienced.
His energy was very dense, very very dark and very intimidating. It's a kind of vibe that if it's bothering you, if that kind of a person is, harassing you, the first instinct would not be to usse bhidne ka man nahi karega. Pehle एक इंटेलिजेंट इंसान के दिमाग में आएगा कि इसके बारे में कंप्लेन करते हैं. दैट इज हु आई हैव ऑलवेज बीन. आई एम नॉट अ कन्फ्रंटेशनल पर्सन ऑल माय लाइफ एंड आई थिंक दिस इज लाइक डिवाइन डिजाइन दैट आई एम ऑलवेज पुट इन सिचुएशंस.
यू रिग्रेट नॉट कन्फ्रंटिंग हिम?
आई कुडंट बिकॉज दैट इज नॉट इवन द कल्चर दैट वी ग्रो अप इन वेयर यू कन्फ्रंट द पीपल. यू नो व्हाट डू आई से, व्हाट वुड आई हैव सेड टू हिम? यू नो आई जस्ट वेंट एंड कंप्लेंड अबाउट हिम बिकॉज ही इज नॉट सपोज टू बी देयर. दैट इज अ फैक्ट. What he's doing is wrong. That's a fact. So I went and complained and they said we'll take care of it. I was fuming with anger, you
Tanushree,
know.
You said that I just want to go through some of the contradictions as people are now saying. I want you to give me the other perspective, because you said there were incidents preceding this on the same sets. Now, Rakesh Sarang, who's director of that film, Horn OK Please, says she misunderstood the enthusiasm of Mr. Nana Patekar.
Enthusiasm?
She misunderstood the enthusiasm of Nana Patekar. There were so many people on the sets. If somebody wanted to do it. Why would they do it in front of everyone? So, in other words, the director who signed you on is doubting the claim of public harassment.
Enthusiasm. Like, is that seriously? I mean, I don't appreciate such enthusiasm. Nobody does. When you're not supposed to be on set, don't be on set. When you're not supposed
to. Did he say that to you when you complained about it?
Who?
Rakesh
Sarang. No, he didn't say that. That point of time.
He was there. He accepted it.
When I complained about him in my van, when I had called him, he said, "Haan, you know, usko nahi hona chahiye. Haan, theek hai, sort out kar. Don't worry, sort out kar denge." Their response was like, when I said, "Ki wo kar kya kya raha hai set pe? Kyun hai yahan pe?" You know, and then now he's teaching me how to dance. So their attitude was, senior actor hai, kuch bol nahi sakte. Kya, kaise wapas?
Yeah, but Sami Siddiqui makes it about, he's the producer of the film. He makes it about your inability to work together with others. He said these are all allegations. There is no truth in it at all. If two people can't work together, it becomes difficult for a producer to get them to work. My point to you is, now that this is going down the legal route, why don't you answer the other side to counter these claims?
No, I'm answering
was
that.
Was he there on the set?
Who?
Sami Siddiqui?
Yes.
He was
absolutely.
There. He was there.
Yeah, he was there on set when this whole situation was happening.
He's saying you just had a working problem.
No. When I said that I'm not going to do this step.
Do you tell him why?
Because I'm uncomfortable. I said,
you told him?
I told him.
You told him he's harassing?
I told him. Arre, unko to complain kiya tha 2 ghante pehle. Tino ko alag alag bula ke maine bola tha. So, complaint to ho chuki thi. Unko pata bhi tha ki ye प्रॉब्लम है तो प्रॉब्लम के ऊपर क्यों थोप रहे हो फिर मुझे एक डांस स्टेप जिसमें उसको टच करना है तो व्हाट आई अंडरस्टूड दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम इज हाउ डेयर यू कंप्लेन अबाउट माय प्रॉक्सिमिटी नाउ यू हैव टू डू अ डांस स्टेप वेयर आई कैन फील यू अप कंप्लीटली एंड यू कैनट इवन से एनीथिंग अबाउट इट
फीलिंग दैट ही वाज at that point of time that he was actually pushing this to happen,
yeah.
That Nana Patekar was remote controlling this, that he showed his power by telling the producer and director she doesn't want to respond to me, make her include a scene in which I can feel her up, in which I will physically harass her, include a scene where I can officially harass her, put her down, and that's my way of getting back, humiliate her publicly.
Yeah. And I could see through that, and that's why I put my foot down, because I knew what I was setting my, I knew I was being set up, and I could not allow my soul, my spirit could not allow me to go through
it. After all these years, when you come out here, people slut shame you, they say personal things about you. Some people say, if she wears these kinds of clothes, what is her problem? Some people say, what's the big deal? The most disgusting, revolting things are said by people like Rakhi Sawant. I mean, words which cannot be repeated again. Everyone's blaming you out here after all of this. I saw the footage of your car being attacked, right? You know what? I think it was a possible lynching.
Yeah, it was a lynching.
And a member of the media was lynching. You say that not only was I harassed, but the MNS attacked me. There was a mob lynching situation that I had to face. One of the attackers in this video, this man called Pawan Bhargav, says your father broke the camera and instigated the mob. He says, I started hitting the car with my camera in my frustration.
Where, we have some more video footages that we found out today. At that point of time, we were preparing to launch a case, a court case.
And you have it?
I have those footages, and I was today only we discovered that we have, because the footages that came out randomly from netizens, right?
Of course.
They came out from somewhere.
Yeah.
But I remembered that 10 years back when we were trying to, prepare a case, and I'll tell you why we didn't, how we were discouraged for it, like scheming, manipulative, a way that we were discouraged from it. So I told Dad, I said, I remember we had collected those footages from a media agency. You know, you can do that. Like, if you want everything that has happened, you can contact an agency
of
and
course.
Tell them, ye 3 mahine mein is topic par jo jo nikla hai, wo
you have the footage.
Yeah, I have a lot of footages. So you will see, you can see in the footage, even the footage that came out, where you see me coming out of the van, where do you see my dad attacking anybody? You just see me coming out of the van and my dad helping me inside the...
Release the footage.
Yes, I mean, I have not myself seen the footages.
See, Tanushree, as much as I respect you for coming out right now and I appreciate all of this, why haven't you aggressively pursued the legal route till now?
So,
why now?
No, let me...
Why is that?
So, that night, after the mob lynching and everything finished, the attack finished, we were all shaken up, the cops came and rescued us from the studio, like, you know, that environment where we were getting attacked from all corners. Believe me, Arnab, I was sitting there in the car and thinking.
What was in your mind then?
I was thinking if there's a hospital nearby.
For?
Because all our glasses, windshield and everything was broken. There was a guy jumping on top of the car so we could also hear, like, it was very scary. And my dad was there, right in front. And the samne wala windshield, na, it was cracking. And I had this visual of someone just grabbing, you know, putting their hand inside and grabbing him and trying to. I was just thinking that if he gets hurt. And my mom's scared. So I'm afraid that, am I going to reach home? Are we going to reach home? So my mind was racing. I know I looked like I was just blah. I think I was so shocked that it was a lot of shock. And it was like also I was thinking like, control, like what am I going to do next? You know, we'll go to the hospital and blah, blah, blah. So anyways, the cops rescued us, took us to the cop station. And the moment I sat in front of the cop who was taking my complaint, I related everything to him. Everything the way I'm telling you.
Yeah, but why didn't you demand an FIR?
They were
why did you
an
let
FIR?
It go rather than chasing and demanding justice?
They did an FIR. There is an FIR.
There is a complaint. You filed a complaint with the police.
No, it's an FIR. Like, if something like this has happened, and if we've gone to the cop station, then they're supposed to take an FIR.
You are a confident, well-spoken young woman. You know your rights. You've been a Miss India. You have the ability and the grit to decipher right from wrong. You have yourself said this is not just your fight. It's about each and every woman. So my question to you is this, and don't mistake this for cynicism. Why are you combating Nana Patekar fully legally only in 2018 and not between 2008 and 2018? Okay. Hold me back. What held you back from filing a specific case of criminal intimidation, taking a lawyer, filing a case of criminal intimidation under Section 503, for the use of force under Section 349 of the IPC when the attack happened? Why didn't you just sit at the police station and demand that the law and order authorities work to deliver justice on your complaint? Filing a complaint is one thing.
Taking it
the next step forward is another.
Arnab, we are simple small town folks. We don't understand all this. And you have to remember, I went to the set that day to shoot. I would never have imagined in my wildest dreams that the day would end like this.
Retrospect, later, next day, perhaps?
I was shaken up. I was shaken up for years after that.
Please. No, but that's.
We went to the cop station. I just know this, that I told them everything exactly the way it's happened. And I saw this one guy, other cop. So I'm telling the story to one cop and the other cop guy is writing, okay? So in my mind, my complaint, my FIR, whatever it is.
You've done what you had to do.
I've done what I had to do. Okay. Now they asked us to sign it. I'm always queasy signing documents unless I read them through. One more thing I remember. पूरा मैंने बताया उसको क्या क्या हुआ देन द कॉप्स आस्किंग मी अच्छा नाना का नाम डालना है इसमें सो आई लुक ही इज आस्किंग मी नाना का नाम डालना है मैंने पूरी कहानी बताई पूरा सब कुछ कि नाना ने ऐसे बिहेव किया फिर ऐसा हुआ फिर मुझे फोर्स कर रहे थे डांस स्टेप करने को फिर ये गुंडे आ गए फिर ये जर्नलिस्ट आ गए ये वो पूरी कहानी बताई जो मैं आज मैं बोल रही हूँ ठीक है पूरा सब कुछ बताने के बाद ही इज आस्किंग मी नाना का नाम डालना है क्या इसमें आई गॉट पिस्ड ऑफ एट हिम बिकॉज नाउ माई इमोशंस आर ऑल फ्लाइंग राइट आई वॉज नॉट एज सेटल्ड एंड काम एंड कंपोज एंड आर्टिकुलेट एज आई एम टूडे दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम सो आई फ्लाई इन टू दिस इमोशनल स्टेट एंड आई सेड एंड आई रिमेंबर सेइंग दैट द कॉप पूरी राम कहानी मैंने आपको सुनाई दी आप मेरे को पूछ रहे हो कि रावण का नाम डालना है तो ही इज लाइक नहीं क्योंकि उनका नाम आप डालोगे तो फिर आपका भी नाम आएगा
The police was scaring you.
At that point of time, I did not doubt the police. At that point of time, I thought ki aisa hi hota hoga shayad. Police, you know, this must be the procedure.
What did you say?
He told me this.
You asked him to put Nana's name.
Nee, so he told me ki aapka bhi naam aayega. So my next response was, mera naam kyu aayega? Maine kya kiya hai? He's like, madam, ye police karwai hi to aisi hi hoti hai. Aapka bhi naam aayega. Counter FIR wo baju mein kar rahe hain. Unka unme aapka naam include karenge. To police karwai mein aap bhi involve ho jaoge. Aapko bhi baar baar police station aana padega. To aap soch lo kya karna hai.
Then?
So then I was flabbergasted. I did not want to say anything ki nahi aap naam mat dalo ki dalo. I said ki nahi, this is my truth. Maine jo bola aapko, maine sach bata diya. Abhi aapko jo karna hai karo.
Then after that?
After that they made us sign the document. Theek hai? I was uncomfortable signing it and I was like, I want to go home and read it. So then they said ki no, if you've told the story right now, you have to sign it right now. Otherwise, the complaint is if you don't sign it right now.
I understand you signed. Then what happened?
I signed it. Then we went home.
Then
after going home, I was watching the TV footage of all of this. And there were some footages of the MNS people. That's the footage I'm trying to look for now.
Then what happened?
Nothing.
What did you do after?
I'm in a state of shock.
No, but you're in a state of shock. But what did you do then?
Do nothing. Just kind of get over the whole thing.
Don't mind my asking you this. Did you feel that if you push too hard, they would throw you out of the industry?
I was already being thrown out of the industry.
After this incident,
I spoke to the media and I was trying to counter the claims made by them.
What do you mean you were already thrown out of the industry? You said that. Why?
Because when something like this happens and such a bawal happens, I knew it was over for me any which ways.
Over?
Yeah.
What emotional effect did it have on you? You must have had some aspirations, some dreams, some career goals for yourself. You were a Miss India and you were very well spoken.
Really,
I mean, did the fact that you stood up to this have a debilitating effect on your career? I'm sure you were 24, you were completely cognizant of the fact that whatever you did that day, they would throw you out, they would gang up against you, because that's how they operate.
They were ganging up against me. Then, and you know, see, with me now, my brain, how it functions, I know what I have to do in this moment. Main utna nahi sochu dur ka, because if you think that far now, you will get paralyzed with fear.
The first thing I did is
answer back the allegations, because while my car was getting attacked, they were giving media interviews.
No, I'm asking you after that.
So many interviews kiya na, for the next 2-3 days I was giving media interviews and telling ki, no,
that,
this is the story,
no,
this
but
is
after
the story.
That, what effect did it have on you, this incident?
This incident, it shook me, it rattled me, it broke my spirit. I had never imagined I would ever be attacked by a mob.
And on your career?
See, the
honestly tell me, Tanushree, what effect did this have on your career?
I'll tell you.
Because we know why I'm asking you this. See, listen, be candid with you. You're being projected as this person who is coming back to seek
revenge
and a career that was denied to her, right? And therefore I'm repeatedly asking you, what impact did this have on your career? Because
it had drastic impact on my life and career.
Did they stereotype you? Did they deny you work?
Immediately after this controversy, because I spoke up in the media and I defended myself, I got about 30 to 40 film offers right after this. Okay. But I did not trust anybody anymore. When you go through this kind of a trauma, this kind of situation, you are anyways shaken up. You are anyways dealing with a lot of other stuff, right?
Like
fear, like intimidation, being in a mob situation where you don't know whether you're going to come out alive or not, that stays with you. It's like a trauma that you don't forget. Like, I would wake up in the middle of the night sometimes at 3 o'clock, ghabrahat me, and then I would wake up and I'd be like, hey, I'm safe. I'm actually in my bedroom and there's nothing happening, you know? It's not like I would see a dream. I would just wake up freaked out. So it has an effect on your psyche. And it was so evil, the whole thing, that anyways my spirit broke. So when these people were offering me movies, I was getting irritated with them. Every time a movie offer would come, my dad would come to me and say, hey, there's a movie offer. Usually when you hear those words, your soul leaps for joy, not mine. My heart would start beating fast. I would, you know, like, heart thande ho jate the mere. The moment my dad would come and say, because all the calls used to come to him, or the manager used to call, manager used to get the calls, and the manager would call my dad. So my dad, he remembers clearly, every time he'd come in and telling me, is banner se aya hai, offer, ye film hai. And I'm just looking at him, heart racing, like frozen. And then I'd be like, abhi man nahi kar raha hai, wo baad mein karenge. You know, baad mein karte karte, maine sare film offers mana kar diye. Then
You didn't do any films?
No, I did a few, Apartment and one South Tamil film, one more I did. But something was just, I didn't want to be here anymore. So I slowly moved away. Also in 2009, I had a spiritual encounter. This was the darkest phase of my life, because I was so indignant with the way Sinta handled things.
Yeah.
That's another story. Sinta calls me, okay, sometime later after this incident, and I'm feeling like, oh, they're calling me to help me. They heard about this, calling me to help me. I go for the meeting. There is this long table.
I just want to tell our viewers that Sinta is the Cine and TV Artists Association, and in an official statement just 3 days back mentioned that the complaint you filed with them in March 2008 and said the chief grievance of sexual harassment wasn't even addressed, which means that you had taken your fight to an industry body and the industry body went against you.
Yeah.
So it's you on one side and the cold response of the entire industry body. What is the use of having an industry body that legitimizes sexual harassment?
And Arnab, the other weird thing about this, it was so bizarre. I go for the Sinta meeting. Okay, they call me. The Sinta people call. So I'm thinking this is for me. When I go there, I realize that this is not for me. This is to further accuse me. Because the Producers Association was there with Sami
Siddiqui. Did you ever approach the big stars?
No, because I
didn't
know them.
Did any big stars speak for you?
No.
Did you know them?
No, I didn't know them. I had never worked with them. They never...
You know, I find it shocking. You heard what Amitabh Bachchan said?
Yeah.
Speak up. You know what he said?
I know.
And if the problem in our country is nobody says anything to Amitabh Bachchan.
No, but I already said He's, it when people asked me about
said,
that
he
comment.
He said, I am not Tanushree and I am not Nana Patekar, hence I have no view on this.
I mean, it's sad that somebody who does movies on women empowerment and then writes blogs and letters and stuff, you know, when the problem is actually in your backyard, you don't have anything to say suddenly. Like, if you saw Bollywood and some of these big stars, they had such, you know, things to say for the Me Too movement that happened, like Saat Samundar Paar.
What about the politically correct Aamir Khan said nothing about it?
You know, Arnab, there's so much shit that I'm dealing with. When I hear this now, that this one said this and that one said that, I'm like blank. I'm like, yeah, it's expected. I'm not surprised, actually. Mm. I'm not surprised. Like, the people who spoke in my favor are the ones who have been outspoken. They have been speaking about issues. Mm. They are the new generation that don't play safe. And that's why they get trolled also so much. Mm. And then there are these oldies who
kind of...
But
come on, you know, in this industry, nobody speaks. All the quote-unquote A-listers are always quiet in this complicity. Nobody spoke. In our country, Sachin Tendulkar does not speak about match fixing. And neither does Salman Khan speak about this incident. He looked irritated. I think there was a very good reporter who asked him a very series of questions on this. Salman Khan looked irritated. I'm not surprised because he's the man who talks about how a woman walks after she's been raped. And he imitated that. It's sickening.
You know, these people, they wanted to go away.
They wanted to go away.
They wanted to go away.
What do you mean by they wanted to go away?
They are so uncomfortable with it. This concept of sexual harassment is so uncomfortable
Why?
For them because it's rampant in our industry. It is everywhere. Like, we've heard in hushed whispers of stories, of horror stories through the years. So this is something, it is happening.
You know, I also felt that way, the reaction. I felt that most of these people, their reaction is, well, it happens. What's the big deal? A, didn't she know it would happen to her when she came in?
No, I know I didn't. I was a Miss India. Mm-hmm. I was not desperate to get into movies. I came back from Miss Universe, and Arnab, 3 days after I came back from Miss Universe, somebody had gotten my number from Times of India, which is the parent company of Miss India pageant, and gotten my number and called me and asked me, do you want to act in movies? And I was like, yeah, well, I didn't win Miss Universe, so I thought I could humor myself a little by doing movies, because I was heartbroken that I didn't win Miss Universe. Although I placed in top 10. So when I came back, in those 3 days was my grieving period. I was supposed to be grieving for the next week or two about not wearing the crown, because I believed that I was not coming back to India, that I would be wearing the crown and, you know, traveling the world. So can you imagine, I come back and I'm sad, and then this movie offer comes, and so I took it like, okay, maybe this is God's will. This is, you win some, you lose some. Maybe I should become a movie star. So I took up the movie, and then subsequently I had more movies, one after the other. So, because of my attitude, perhaps I also, I'm not even saying attitude, and that's a really wrong thing to say. Maybe it was grace that I did not come across such things, and I know I wasn't expecting it.
Why didn't you speak about Vivek Agnihotri before? The allegations against Nana Patekar you've spoken about Vivek Agnihotri allegedly told you, jao jaake kapde utar ke nacho usko cues do, during his film Chocolate. He has sent you a legal notice. Right? Truth, I believe, is the counter to defamation. And I think you need to tell the country about what happened on the sets of Chocolate. And did you speak about it?
I spoke early. To everybody about it, because I'm not the kind of woman who keeps quiet. If somebody says something to me, I will, even though I was kind of a little non-confrontational, but I would go and tell somebody about
it. But his associate director in the film, Satyajit, who said he worked closely with you, said you had a bad habit of disappearing in her van.
That
you
is,
didn't understand that in a multiple camera setup, you didn't understand. And she says that the media has made it sound as if she was asked to strip, which is absolutely false. The entire system within Tanushree is making it out to be like you're making a mountain out of a molehill.
Okay, let me tell
Respond clearly to it, yeah.
Obviously, these guys are going to come up with all these things, right? Getting inside the van and not coming out and all that is bullshit. To kind of make me look like
insinuation.
Me look like somebody who cannot be trusted.
Yeah.
Chocolate was one film where Vivek did not want me to be a part of the film. The producers were 5 women, and they were very sure that I would do the film because I was a new Miss India. I was still wearing my crown. Vivek, on the other hand, I did 7 screen tests for that movie, and from day one, I knew this guy doesn't like me. He doesn't want me to be a part of the movie. In fact, during the casting process, I even saw in
what. But did he ask you to strip?
Yeah. He was mean to me right from day one. He just hated me because I still got the part despite the fact that he didn't want me to do the film. He wanted other girls to be a part of the film. So from day one, he was always constantly trying to make me uncomfortable. This particular song sequence, I was wearing something very skimpy and there was rain, you know, water wing poured out on me. It was Bhiga Bhiga December song. So because of the water and everything, I was developing some fever. At one point of time, I went and told him also that, you know, I'm developing fever. Can you put the AC down? I told the production didn't do it. They said ki aap director se bolo. So unko maine bola. So he said, he's telling me, tumko tumhare kya? Tumhare liye sare unit ko garmi mein sadne de kya? So I heard it and I was like, whatever, that's really mean to do something like that. I'm telling him I have fever.
No, but did he ask you to?
And after that, yes, he did that. And after that, he would never let me go to my van. My entire shooting for Chocolate, you know how it was. I used to be the first person to be called on set before any actor, before even the ADs sometimes.
But
I would
did
be
he
upset.
Ask you to take?
Yes, yes.
Did he? Yes. Did he do that?
Yes. There was this one song sequence where, you know, this same day, my fever day, I'm standing behind the camera with my robe and everything. And Irfan's close-up shot, just his face, tight shot. This guy tells me, "Jao jaake kapde utar ke nacho, cues do usko." So I just look at him and I'm shocked, you know, and I'm thinking, ki, should I obey that command? Because it's so offensive. It's
he's not given a legal notice to you. You still, yeah, you don't care.
I don't care. Anyways, he's given you a legal notice. Right. So I can tell him everything that he did throughout the film.
Sure.
You know, so I'm thinking, like, I'm shocked. I'm like, how can someone speak to me like that? And I'm also thinking, ki, uska response main kaise karu? So meanwhile, Irfan Khan spoke up because they were mortified. Everybody was shocked. He's crude. He's crude and obnoxious. So Irfan Khan spoke up. He's like, "Nahi, nahi, cues dene ki zarurat nahi hai. Mujhe acting aati hai. Usko cues dene ki kya zarurat hai? You keep wearing your robe." Because they all knew I had fever. And they all knew that this guy would blast the AC full on. And, you know, I was still being made to work. And then immediately Sunil Shetty also spoke up. He was also mortified. So he spoke in a sarcastic tone. And he said, "Main aao kya cues dene ke liye? Bakwas karte ho." And he reprimanded the guy. So this guy backed off. Throughout the shooting, whenever these actors would be present, I'm now talking about Vivek Agnihotri and Chocolate.
Do you realize one thing? Vivek Agnihotri complains that all of Bollywood is against him because he's got certain political views. But in this particular case, the irony is that all of Bollywood is for him.
For
because
him?
He's taking you on. There's nobody who's questioned Vivek Agnihotri in this case, the majority. I mean, you do understand.
Half
I think it's. I think
doesn't
it's,
know him.
No, no, but I'm saying it's very remarkable that you're speaking up and fighting for justice when you're against a very, very connected and power-wielding system.
Arnab,
you are against
Vivek
a very,
Agnihotri
very...
Is...
No, no, I'm not about Vivek Agnihotri. As I speak today, Akshay Kumar is shooting Houseful 4 with your alleged harasser, Nana Patekar.
Yes.
Truth be told, you know, what has Bollywood done? Beyond
nothing.
The occasional tweets to boycott Nana Patekar, Amitabh Bachchan has said, "My name is not Tanushree Dutta." And Salman Khan has said, "I'm not aware of this." He talks like a lawyer nowadays. Let me understand what is happening. Fact is, the big wigs are quipping at your allegations.
Yeah.
Why?
Well, that's a question that
you need
to ask them.
Amir Khan,
their own conscience.
What is the conscience? Speak up, Tanushree.
Because I don't know why they are dodging it. I don't know why they think it's okay for something like this to happen. I don't know why they think that, there's harassment is rampant in our industry, and I think everybody had kind of taken it for granted that this is normal and that you have to live with it and you cannot complain about it. So when
you know what Saroj Khan had said, she had said that on the casting couch in April this year, she said, "Wo to roti to bhi deti hai, rape karke chhod to nahi deti." She spoke about the casting couch in the industry. Did you hear this?
She
was normalizing assault. She said, "There is assault, but we provide a living. We provide food because we assault. We don't rape people and leave them on the streets."
Oh my God, that is like so medieval.
And Salman Khan said, "When I used to walk out of that ring," talking about a film where he did wrestling, he said, "I used to feel like a raped woman walking out."
Yeah, our society is so misogynistic and so...
Society, you know, or Bollywood?
Bollywood is a fraternity within a community, right? So they all come from the same neev to wahi hai na, udhar se panpe hai, janme hai. They are not like dropped from heaven to have completely different kind of creatures. They've come from amongst us. They've come from the same society. They've had the same kind of upbringing.
So now they've got to give a motive to what you're doing. So they're saying that you want to go to Big Boss.
I know, this is hilarious. One doesn't have to.
You want to go
do...
to Big Boss?
No.
If you get a call, will you go to Big Boss?
I know. Do you really think my aspirations
I think
in life
nothing.
Will be
I have,
so?
No, I don't have great views
no,
on.
No, no, no. Of course, not but, you. But I'm saying, like, since we are talking for the viewers.
Because the MNS has gone and threatened the channel apparently that
it's
if you
comedy.
Take her on Big Boss.
I want to say something to the people of this country. What you think is a great aspiration, I may not think that. You think Salman Khan is God and Big Boss is heaven. I don't think that. Right? And second fact, you don't have to do anything to get into Big Boss. Big Boss chases people any which ways to join Big Boss. They want to pay you shitloads of money to join Big Boss. And they've been after me for the last 10, 12 years.
They have.
They have offered me crores.
They have.
Yes, to get into Big Boss. And I've said no.
Over the years.
Over the years. I have said no. When they get behind a celebrity, they can literally stalk you. They're
so
very persistent.
That's interesting, yeah.
So
you've been saying no.
Exactly. I've been saying no. So, I mean, if I had to get inside Big Boss, I would have done so earlier. Why now when I'm living in America? Logic. Why would I come back from America after 2 years
Tell me
and
something.
Not spend time with my family and go into Big Boss?
Yeah.
I'm claustrophobic anyways. I cannot stay in that manner where my freedom is threatened.
No.
I need to move around and I need to have freedom. I don't even know what I'm doing.
No, I don't. I've never
now.
Even watched Big Boss, but I'm just asking you because everyone
it's so toxic.
Says,
why would I go
well,
to
I
Big
don't
Boss?
Know. I know. You know something? I believe in debate. I just believe in debate. All I've done all
this
my life.
This is a way to discredit me. And that's a Big Boss thing. She's doing this to go to Big Boss.
Okay, so tell me one thing, Tanushree. Tell me, it's not like I'm not just throwing a dare. Will you come face to face with Nana Patekar? Are you ready to face him?
Of course. He's not ready to face me. He cannot face me.
If from your side, it said, okay, if I call him on the program, you are ready to confront him face to face.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I would face him and
you
I will. Yes. Because
he says I'll do a press conference. I think that's one-way communication. I think the important thing for him is to come face to face with you and hear you speaking to him. This... I don't believe in making private matters public. When this matter is public, then I think it's necessary for him to face
it. I have no qualms. Like, although I feel like he's a disgusting man who has still not taken responsibility for his actions. Also, another thing I want to mention, a lot of people are making this hue and cry. Why didn't she do a court case and this
True.
And that? I want to say this. 10 years back, I was intimidated, harassed and threatened against
Sure.
a court case. There was some guy, okay, who was Nana's friend. But he was pretending to be our well-wisher. He communicated with a friend of mine, said, I want to help Tanushree. When my friend told me, oh, this is Nana's lawyer or friends, my first thing was, why would I want to speak to Nana's lawyer? Then the next day she called me and she said, no. He knows Nana. He wants to help you. Any which ways, the meeting was set up. This guy came home and he's telling, Nana wants to do a court case on you, but don't worry, I will convince him to not do it. Because you're a woman and everything, and I'm really concerned about you. Okay.
So Nana Patekar sent a via media to issue
a
threat.
Who's this guy? Indirectly. He is a high court judge today. I don't remember his name, but I will ask my dad.
A high court judge?
Yes.
A person who was a lawyer and now a high court judge
yes.
came to you as
yes.
an agent of Nana Patekar to issue a threat.
Yeah. And
this
the thing is
bizarre.
Even if I find his name out, my dad would remember. He will simply deny because he's like, no, I don't know Nana Patekar. I was simply there to help her. Nana will say, I don't know him.
So my question goes back.
Let me tell you what exactly happened. And then on the same hand, he's also trying to find out what we are thinking of doing. आप लोग कोर्ट केस करना चाहते हो क्या करना चाहते हो आप लोग ठीक है तो वी आर क्लूलेस राइट वी आर जस्ट लाइक हमारे साथ इतना कुछ हो गया है अब तो हमारा दिमाग ही काम नहीं कर रहा है तो आया है बंदा हमें हेल्प करने की कोशिश कर रहा है वी आर ऑल्सो कन्फ्यूज एंड टुडे आई एम वाइजर स्मार्टर ओल्डर आई फील सो स्टूपिड दैट वी इवन अलाउड समबडी टू कम इन टू आवर होम एंड थ्रेटन अस ही सेइंग देन वी आर सेइंग पता नहीं आप बताओ सो ही इज लाइक नहीं कोर्ट कचहरी के चक्कर में मत पड़ो क्योंकि अभी तो पुलिस स्टेशन के चक्कर लगा रहे हो और ये कोर्ट वोट के चक्कर में पड़ोगे तो 5-10 साल के कोर्ट के चक्कर लगाओगे और नाना इज वेरी श्योर ही इज वेरी ऑफेंडेड ही वांट्स टू यू नो सू यू बट मैं उनको समझा दूंगा डोंट वरी मैं समझा वो नहीं करेगा आपके ऊपर कोर्ट केस. एंड आई रिमेंबर ड्यूरिंग दैट वन कॉन्वर्सेशन ही सेड समथिंग टू द इफेक्ट कि जब मैंने पूछा होगा कि वो कोर्ट केस करेगा तो कैसे, ही इज़ लाइक नहीं वो थोड़ा कार्रवाई चलती है, एक आध दिन के लिए अगर लॉकअप में डाल देंगे तो प्रॉब्लम हो जाएगा ना. सो यू सी वी आर ब्रेक्ड आउट, वी हैव जस्ट गॉन थ्रू दिस होल थिंग एंड हियर इज दिस गाय स्टैंडिंग.
आर यू सेइंग दैट यू आर ओके टू कमिंग ऑन अ डिबेट विद नाना पाटेकर? वेरी पॉइंटेडली आई एम आस्किंग यू.
यू नो दैट मैन क्रीप्स मी आउट.
नो बट आर यू विलिंग टू फ्रॉम योर साइड?
आई डोंट नो, दिस इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी दैट आई डिड नॉट कंसीडर.
इफ ही अग्रीज,
बट आई विल ब्लास्ट द शिट आउट ऑफ हिम.
Yeah.
Because he knows he's wrong.
So can I?
He can hide and attack me, but in front of me, he cannot do anything.
Can I send an official request to him?
Do I want to put myself in that position?
You said you want to blast him. I mean, I think let's see if he responds.
I'm confused. Yeah, let's see if he responds. Let's take a call on it.
Okay. Yeah. So I'll send a letter out. Let's see if he responds. But you know, I think you're very transparent. You've spoken quite freely. You've recounted everything. Not a shred of doubt in the truth of what you've said. I also want to tell you that perhaps very few people will be able to empathize truly with what you've been through.
Yeah, because they've not been
through it. But I don't think you came back for this.
I didn't. Because I told you, my concerns before I took the flight, Arnab, was the heat in India, my wardrobe. Because in US right now, in the summers, everyone's wearing shorts and hot pants and walking around. So my concern with my friends was, hey, I have these clothes. Maybe I should just pick out some conservative clothes because anyways, I get trashed a lot in India.
Yeah.
So maybe I should not wear this. Those were my concerns, the heat and my clothes.
Mm.
And I was nervous coming to India after so long. And because I didn't want to come and the situation was such that I had to come. Who knew? If God told me that this is what's going to happen, I would never have come back. I never wanted to come back to India.
Well, God moves in mysterious ways.
Yes.
And unexpected things happen.
Yeah.
But thank you for coming. And I think you are a very, very courageous person. I do think that you are.
I don't know. I mean, I find myself in this. If someone told me to be here, I wouldn't. Not again.
Yeah.
So I don't know if that's the definition of courage.
Well, it's
like
not,
when you're there, you
courage is
have
not
to
planned, Tanushree. So in that sense, you are incredibly brave. So hang in there.
Okay.
And all the best.
Pleasure.
Good talking to you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to The Nation Wants to Know. With me here in the studio today is Tanushree Dutta, and she needs no introduction now. She's been in the headlines for about a week now.
Yeah.
A little longer than a week. I spoke to Tanushree a few days back and I invited her to one of my programs and debate shows in the evening. At that time, she said she was not completely